Hi children, today we shall complete the chapter Measures to Reduce Pollution, where we learn about the importance of saving the environment. Now, from where do you think they got the idea from? From where do you think people felt that there is a need to save the environment? I give you three options. They saved the environment because they felt that cutting down trees caused harm to the environment. Trees give us fruits and vegetables and other benefits. So if we cut down the trees, we won't get all these benefits. And the last option I give you is, they had the love for trees. Now what do you think is the correct answer? Try and give me a guess. Actually, the truth is, all these answers are important and all these answers are correct. Most importantly, they had the love for trees. They loved nature. They took care of trees like their own children. And that's when we moved to a very special movement that took place 300 years ago in a village called Khejari in Rajasthan, where people did not care about losing their lives to save the trees. How did they do that? They hugged the trees all the time and they did not allow the contractors and the strangers to cut them. And this gives rise to a new movement called as Chipko Movement. We will learn about it through a story. Come, read along with me. A girl called Amrita lived in a village in Rajasthan called Khejari. This village is in the beautiful desert state of India. The name of the village was named after a tree that grows in this village called the Khejari tree. The tree is mainly found in such desert areas. It can grow without much water. It is a very useful tree because it is used for many reasons. The fruit is used as vegetables called beans. Village people loved trees. They worshipped and took care of trees. Villagers showed love towards animals and plants. People of Khejari village belonged to the Bishnoi sect. The Khejari tree is of great importance. It is used in many ways. The bark of a tree is used as medicines. The wood is so good that it does not get affected by insects. And children like you like to play under the shade of this tree. Amrita made friends with the trees and talked to them every day. She greeted them every morning. After years, Amrita went to greet her trees. She saw there were some strangers in her village. They said that the king Maharaja Abhay Singh of Mewar had sent them to cut the trees and they wanted the wood for construction to build the king's palace. Amrita shouted and soon hugged the trees, but the stranger said, "It's the king's order." Amrita and her three daughters hugged the trees and soon the other villagers, old and young, also joined. Many people, including Amrita and her three daughters, died in order to save trees. When the king heard this, he could not believe. He could not believe that people gave up their lives. He visited the village himself. He came to know how much people love the trees. So he ordered, "No tree will be cut," and the village was now protected. This inspired other states in India. The hugging of trees to save the environment was called as Chipko Movement.
Let us revise what is Chipko Movement. Chipko Movement is the hugging of trees by people, especially by women who wanted to protect their environment from strangers. This was an inspiration to other states in India. 300 years later, the same incident took place in a state in India called Uttarakhand. And women here together joined hands to save the environment and even stopped all those contractors and strangers who came to cut the trees for various purposes. We know that trees give us so many benefits like fruits, vegetables, timber, and a lot of things. So if we cut down trees, we get all of these things, but we do not get a healthy environment. So we need to join hands together and save the environment. Even you and me together can save the environment. And how can we do that? By planting trees. Every day we could just water them or plant a new sapling, which in future will become a big tree. And you too can see your tree growing up as you grow older.
Modern Chipko Movement. The movement took place 300 years after the Chipko movement in Khejadi village, taken up by the women in the village. But since this happened way after that, in the modern times, that is the present situation in the state of Uttarakhand in India, this is called as the modern Chipko movement. Let us see some people who have contributed to saving our environment associated with modern Chipko movement. Gaura Devi. Gaura Devi did not think about herself, but she gave her life to save the environment. In line we have Sundarlal Bahuguna and Shamsher Singh Bisht. These two also showed their bravery and were awarded for their bravery in saving the environment. Govind Singh Rawat and Dum Singh Negi, they too showed their love towards the environment and nature. Two other brave women were Bachni Devi and Sudesh Devi. Chandi Prasad Bhatt was the activist who, along with his other companions, went on saving the environment and stopped the cutting of trees.
We shall now discuss the final part of our chapter, that is the steps to reduce pollution. These are the steps that you and I can take at a basic level or at the individual level to save the environment. These are just brief points, children, towards the end of the chapter. Proper disposal of waste, that is segregation of waste into proper bins. Reduce, recycle and reuse, the three R's that are very important. Planting more and more trees, this should be encouraged. We should at least plant one sapling in a week. Stop burning of garbage and do not burn plastic. You can keep it separately and your garbage collector will come and collect it. Read the chapter carefully, understand the concepts, learn the spellings of the lesson, and take care. Thank you.